have been stuck on the moon for about 4 days now. And we are so dumb that we still have no idea how to fuel
our oxygen tanks.
So, we've literally just been stuck
in this bubble.
I think I've had enough of him. Look at, like, just look at him. Look at him. He stinks.
He's smelly.
He doesn't clean up after himself. He doesn't use toilet paper!
I mean, the man is not easy to live with. Although, I do feel like we have bonded a little bit over this time. Basically, we're just waiting for Jack, our savior and grace, to come literally save us. Because we are going to die soon. Either from lack of oxygen, or from hunger, or from boredom. I want you guys to leave a like if you think Jack will come and save us. I think this prank might have gone a little too far, though, because, my life is at stake right now, so I might just have to get him back. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you all go on to enjoy the video.
Yeah, you know how it would be. We got the bow, we got the choo-choo train, the siren.
Like, do you guys see what I'm saying? I have to live with this. I have to live with this guy.
Oh, you're still doing that?
Yeah. All right. We've been stuck together for 4 days, and you haven't showered once. You still aren't using any toilet paper, even though we have it.
Why are you wearing your mask? Like, we
You're
have oxygen.
You're wearing your mask, bro.
Guys, there's no reason to argue, okay? I'm here. I'm
oh,
coming to-
Jack's Oh, he's back! Here oh, she is! Go. Oh, my God!
It's bro. Been 4 days.
Oh, thank you so much.
Let's go.
We've been stuck here waiting for you for
get
so long,
get me away
long,
from
bro.
This kid.
No, get me away from him!
No, you guys are probably hating each other right now, but it's okay. We have big things back at the house.
Like what?
Yeah. Can't tell you yet. We need to make sure that we get back. Okay, Adam, place down. Wait, is this thing fueled up? We need to... Everybody, listen up. Alex, get the fuel.
Bro, we have nothing. We need you to just save us. Like, we have nothing. Okay. We've been stuck here for so long. I haven't left this bubble in 4 days, bro. We've been stuck in this bubble.
I took all the cheeseburgers.
Okay, I need one of you guys to give me the pickaxe.
This is the thing. He thinks he can just come back here and act like we're all friends.
No, shh. Pretend like we're friends for now so that we go back and then we can be mad at him, okay?
Okay, yeah, sorry about that.
I can hear you guys.
Hey, Jack.
Whoa.
What'd you say, friend?
Wait, who has another rocket ship? We need more. All right, you two giant plebs. We should be good to go back to Earth. I know it's been a struggle, but...
Get me out of here! Get me out! Get me out! No, I'm gone. I'm gone. I'm out. See ya.
Thank you, sir. Adam, I'm sorry. I didn't fill you up with enough fuel. You're only going to be able to make it halfway.
Oh, that's fine. That's fine. I'll be lost in space. It's better than spending any more time with this nub.
That's actually a good point. And away we go! Oh, my God! Wait. This is actually so cool. What the heck?
What's happening?
The parachute? Or that you're falling down to Earth?
I'm parachuting down. That is so epic. What the heck?
Oh, wow.
Make sure you wait for the chest to fall, too, because that's where your rocket ship will be.
I don't really want to go back there, to be honest, so I'm okay.
I'm good.
You have to. Oh, I forgot. My tree of cookies is destroyed because somebody burnt it down.
I don't know who would have done that. What a meanie.
Why is my parachute still on me? I've landed already.
Where's my dog? I haven't seen my dog in so long. Where is he? Cooper!
Cooper, fine.
Where is he?
Where's my house at? No! Why is my house still destroyed?
Why would it be back?
Pip, where's Pip?
All right, boys, listen up. We have things to do today. Today is dinosaur day.
Yay! What?
That was the most underwhelming reaction ever.
Dinosaur day! Wait, what does that mean? What does that mean, though? Because last time we had dinosaurs, we died like 1,000 times.
So I don't want to do that again.
Today, we are going to be hatching our dinos at the end of the episode.
Oh,
let's
go.
It's about time.
Very nice.
It's like a month.
Yeah.
Right, we have a book. We will get 20 minutes in creative mode to build the best dinosaur exhibits. The winner of the best exhibit will get another dinosaur to add to their enclosure. I supplied you all with some basic building materials to start. You are not allowed to troll each other during this challenge. You don't want to find out what happens if you do. Good luck. Love, Dino Bessie.
Adam, can you please come here? Jack needs to see you. Jack needs to see you.
What?
just come. Just run over this way, please.
Yeah.
Hey, Alec, why do you still have a parachute?
Oh, I don't have it for me. Adam has one.
What's up?
You look so funny.
Wait, I don't have one.
Wait, you have one for me, though.
What?
All right, so I totally did not listen to what you said.
So,
Why do I even play with you guys? Okay, you basically get 20 minutes in creative mode to build the best dino enclosure. But there's a specific area. I need to give you guys each your dinosaurs. So who had the Dilophosaurus?
That would be the ding-dong over there.
We also have a little weenie Triceratops.
Little weenie? Dude, wait till it's hatched, then you can say that.
Okay, now we also each get an in-gen field guide where we'll be able to see what our dino stats are.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead in creative mode because I need to give you guys one of each of these security fences. These are going to be super important. You're going to want to surround your enclosure with these.
Well, what if I want mine to get out? So should I still do that?
I don't care.
Have you ever watched Jurassic Park? That's never a good idea, bro.
Yeah, my favorite movie. The enclosures are secure.
Wait, are we building the enclosures right here?
No.
Oh, my God. I was going to say.
I need to get new YouTubers. Oh, yeah. Okay, now, if you guys follow me over to Dinosaur Valley, you will see where we are building these bad boys.
Dinosaur Valley? That sounds fancy.
Yeah.
Whoa, what the? Who built this? This is awesome.
Dinosaur Valley, ladies and gentlemen. We have dinosaurs inside. If you guys go up to the second floor, make a sharp right, you will see the tunnel to the back.
Whoa, I don't know how I knew exactly where to go, but I did.
this is epic, bro.
Oh, wow.
So this is where we will be building the enclosures. Everybody gets around 100 blocks to themselves.
Nice. I call it top right quadrant.
No, I want that quadrant.
So how do I know that it's 100 blocks? Do I just guess? Or just kind of
pick a general
area?
Yeah, you can just guess.
Okay, there's a structure over here. Can I just claim this?
And I don't care. All right, here we go. The timer starts in 3, 2, 1. Build.
Okay, like I'm kind of scared, bro. I feel like you've raised like a billion dinosaurs, so you like know exactly what you're doing, you know? Oh wait, I forgot, we're supposed to deafen for this.
Hi guys, welcome to another building tutorial. Today I'm gonna show you guys how to build the most and awesomest and coolest dinosaur ranch thing you've ever seen in your life.
So basically you wanna start with the outside, and then we work our way in. But we gotta set up the barrier first, because it's the most important part to make sure that the dino is nice and enclosed. You know what I'm saying? But you also gotta keep in mind that this is a Triceratops. So we gotta have a lot of space for the big boy. It's not quite as big as a T-Rex, but he's pretty thick. Okay, as I'm building this,
it's looking kind of small, isn't it?
All right, this does not look like the biggest enclosure in the world, but you know what? He's gonna be a baby for a little while. He doesn't need that much space. Maybe when he gets older, we can renegotiate, and he might be able to get some more space like that. But I only have 20 minutes to build this thing, which is not that much time, so...
I just gotta make sure I get it done.
I did grow up playing Zoo Tycoon, though, and in that game, you could get dinosaurs, and you would make them enclosures and stuff. So I feel like, you know, I kind of have some experience of raising dinosaurs in enclosures. I don't even know if I'm doing this right. So if you guys remember, in one of the very first episodes, we had the ability to make an instant house, but there's also a bunch of other instant structures that we can build, such as a horse stable.
An ender gateway, an aqua base, grassy plain. That could be pretty nice.
Oh, here we go. Jurassic Craft plants. This is actually exactly what we want. All right, we're gonna try to make a little bit of a base here of this weird cobble brick thing. I don't know. It's a dinosaur block, so he will be familiar. My goal here is to make my Triceratops feel like he's at home. I don't want him to, you know, be born into an area where he's like,
where the heck am I? I hate it here.
So I'm gonna try to make it as natural as possible. I do feel like I'm running out of time, though. I do feel like that we're starting to run low on time, which is probably not very good, seeing as how I'm literally not even close to being done. I'm trying to build literally as fast as humanly possible, though. I really want him to have different terrains throughout the area. This way, you know, he has an area where he can sunbathe, and one area where he can play with awesome rocks, and one area where he can,
take a nap.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want him to just be like the same thing over and over again. I want it to be different. Like, this area that I'm building right now is gonna be a nice rocky area for him. Oh, look, we got some trees going on, boy!
Oh, nice!
Okay, it's actually starting to come together a little bit. Now, obviously, he's gonna need some water to drink. So, this I'm planning on making a little pond. All right, so if you go ahead and place water there, I'm hoping that it'll just flow all the way down in here, and yes, perfect. We got these weird, funky-looking logs. What we can do, actually, is maybe just put this around, like, the outside as, like, a transition to the grassy lands. Now, I do wish that I gave him a little bit more space over in the grassy area, but I feel like Triceratopses are more in, like, more used to the stony areas, more so than grassy.
I don't know, I'm maybe just making that up.
If you guys do want to see how the other two guys are making out, the only way to actually see is by going to their channel and actually checking out their video for yourselves. I honestly feel like this place is coming along kind of nicely. I feel like the fountain might be missing a little something, though. I don't know what it is, but I feel like adding these slabs around the area is just adding a nice extra little texture, a nice extra little dimension to the whole place. And just adding like random blocks here and there, I feel like gives it some color. And overall, yeah, I feel like it's coming along pretty nicely. Maybe I can make this area right here like a little cave for him to stay in. There we go, here's a nice little cave. Now, I don't know how long he'll be able to fit in this cave for, but for the time that he is still little, it'll be a nice little area for him to chill out at. I hope that he doesn't come up here and just jump out though. That,
that could be pretty bad.
Boom, so now look, he's got this little cave area. It's not the biggest of caves, but it's something a little nice, something that he can work with. Maybe if there's a thunderstorm or something, he can sit under there. Actually, I'm gonna need some nicknames for him as well. So he's gonna eventually be a really, really big, strong Triceratops. So try to come up with some awesome nicknames for that. You know what, guys? I was not expecting me to build something this nice for the guy. I really hope that he enjoys it. He's got like a rocky area, he's got a cave, he's got a pond, he's got grass, he's got trees. Like, what more could I really get for this guy? Hello?
Hey, timer's up.
Oh my goodness, dude. I'm actually pretty happy with the way mine turned out. Do you like yours?
Yeah, I had to make mine so big because it's a flipping T-Rex.
Oh my. I'm seeing a little sneak peek at yours. Oh my god, that looks epic, dude.
Oh, mine is not good at all. Let's just say that.
Right, you can fix it up off camera, but this is a challenge. So, after you guys see each and every enclosure, be sure to vote on whoever's channel you find this on. There'll be a poll in the top right or top left hand of the screen that you can pick out who you think has the best enclosure.
I will say mine is a lot smaller than I want it to be. But they're only going to be babies for now, right? Like, we have time to make them bigger as they grow up.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. I see you guys come check out mine. If you guys do want to see theirs, go check out their channels for the exclusive access to that.
If you guys follow me over this way. Yeah, so I decided to build it right next to a castle so that he always has a very nice view. Thing is, though, the place is really tiny. It's really, really tiny.
Very tiny.
It's cool though. It's like really compact.
This would be great for a Velociraptor, not a Triceratops.
Oh,
you have a Triceratops?
Well, he's gonna be a baby. He's gonna be a baby for the first, couple months, and I figured might as well give him a nice little area to play in. But I got him a nice little pond that he can play in with the waterfall and everything. And then he's got a little cave over here. Look at this little spooky cave. Like, this reminds me of like McDonald's where you go into the playground area.
You know what I'm saying?
This thing's not gonna fit through here in like 2 weeks.
Right, whatever. But then he needed some grass, so I gave him some grass and some trees you know, it's rich in oxygen and stuff. So although I do realize that the place is pretty tiny, I think it's got good quality overall.
Got a lot of potential.
Is there a front door?
No, because I don't think anyone should go in. Like, it's just gonna eat you.
Exactly what I was thinking with my design.
I'm gonna feed him by just hucking over meat, just throwing it over the fence at him.
You need to set up feeders before anything, but I'm going to give it a 10 out of 10 for design, a 5 out of 10 for functionality, and a overall score of a 6.9.
Oh, really? Really? A 6.9, bro? I don't know.
Okay. You're not going to be able to fit a Triceratops in here. A Velociraptor cage, this is perfect.
That makes me sad. Right. Adam, what do you think?
All right, looks alone, like, it's pretty good. I'll give it like an 8.
An 8 for looks?
It looks pretty cool.
Yeah, you gave Jax like a 10 out of 10, and he just put trees everywhere. All right, overall, what are you saying?
Overall, I'm sorry to say, but it's got to be a 6 for practicability. Nah. So right. 6
practicability,
overall, man.
That's not even a word. All right, go away. All right, I'm spawning him in. I'm not even excited to spawn him in anymore. I'm so disappointed.
It's not realistic.
Your opinion doesn't matter. It's the viewers' opinions. They need to vote. And also, if your dinosaur likes it, like, he likes it, you know?
Hey, you could still win this thing.
Oh, my. Look how cute. Dude, he's not too big. This is the perfect size for him.
Oh,
this is literally perfect.
I don't think you remember what a full-size Triceratops looks like.
No, I know. I'm saying since he's a baby, it's perfect baby size. When he gets bigger, I'll build him a bigger
perfect
one.
Perfect baby size.
Just baby-wise, I'd give you a 9.
Yeah, okay, that's what I was building for. I was building for a baby Triceratops.
All right, okay. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. There are all the enclosures. I hope you guys did enjoy. Be sure to vote which one you think is the best in terms of absolutely everything you can think of. I don't even know where my dinosaur went. It's so big.
Yeah, your place is so giant that it's difficult. Like, you're never going
to
find him.
But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, if you guys do want us to add more dinosaurs or more exhibits with other types of animals, be sure to let us know by dropping a like down below. Comment who we should add in next episode to our giant zoo tycoon, pretty much.
Yeah, like, so I guess we can get, like, any... Can we get, like, tigers and stuff? That'd be pretty awesome.
People want to see it.
Let's get a velociraptor.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, be sure to let us know. That is going to wrap it up. My name is Beck Bro Dinosaur Jack.
And my name is Siren Dinosaur Master.
And I am the best designer / base builder, Adam Beck. Beck Bro Adam.
And we'll see you guys all next time. Peace out, dudes.
See ya.
Bye, have a good time.